some has few attributes. Okay, that should come. So one of the important point is not only having the attributes, but another important system task which will stay is to actually update the attributes.
These should be generated on the fly.
This should be generated on the fly. It is, see, none of is search generated on the fly. Google search generated on the fly. It's not generated on the fly. Okay, you crawl, you keep the data and you go and search. Okay. So it depends upon how often you crawl. Okay, it all depends upon how often you crawl and how updated is your data. I can repeat this. He is telling that, see, there is an interesting, I will come to that. There are interesting questions like Barack Obama will have 5,000 attributes. Okay. And he would, because he is popular, he will have attributes all over the world. Okay. But realistically, somebody cannot be expert more than the 20 topics or 30 topics. Okay. Because 30-20 comes in this way that there are reputations like sports and athletes, etc. So there we have actually kept a bar that, okay, the first 20 topics in which he is expert. Because so you understand that this is, why are this big and this are small? Because we have the frequency and we are putting the frequency. So the most frequent 20 topics in which the person is actually coming from. Yeah.
And one more question, like you are fixing number of topics that as 20. So is there any other metric like week give some value to particular topic? If it exceeds that threshold,
sure.
We will include. So is there a metric that has been
we have always concentrated on the system side of view to develop, to deploy. Okay. And these are problems which should be tackled and people should tackle it and then cite our people. Yeah? Okay. So I will come to those parts. Okay. I will come to the difficulties. So always when I am presenting this work, what I am trying to do is I am trying to pose a very rusty. Pose the entire problem as a very rusty problem where we don't know many of the standard techniques. We are just simple engineers who want to develop something. Okay. So I'm presenting it in that way. So I'm just taking 10, I'm taking 20, I'm taking 50. But obviously you can see how the topic is falling. Okay, how the topic frequency is falling. Then we have a cutoff, etc. So one thing happens is even if you do all these sophisticated things, the result improves a bit, but in deployment sense, it doesn't improve a lot to really satisfy the users much more. Okay. Right? Okay. So once you have this, the next question would be the inverse problem. The next question would be the inverse problem. What is the inverse problem? Given a topic, I would like to know what are the people. The next question is just the inverse problem. Okay, so now what are the problems? Let us see. So what is happening is there are 400 million tweets posted. So quality of tweets posted by different users vary widely. Okay. And we have the challenge to find topical experts. One thing. The second thing is, there is an additional challenge that keeping the system up to date in face of thousands of users joining. So that is very important. Why I will tell you. Like when we were working, suddenly we saw that Manmohan Singh joined. Okay. And immediately in 2-3 days he became a politics expert. So now our system, so that will continuously happen. Manmohan Singh joining, Mamata joining, so these things will continuously happen. So you have to have a system which would actually capture that. So there are two problems. One is that we identify experts on topics using lists. That is fine, that is discussed earlier. But we need to, one more thing, we need to rank. There needs to be a ranking algorithm. Okay, we need to rank. I will come to that problem when we talk about ranking. And there is an additional challenge, keep the system up to date in face of thousands of users joining. Okay. So I guess the problem statement is clear. We get from the list the expert, that is fine, but we have to rank and then we have to have this additional challenge of keeping the system up to date. Okay. So now what we did? We did a ranking algorithm based solely on lists. Okay. We ranked based solely on lists. Okay. So two components of ranking using you with respect to query queue, relevance of user to query, buffer distance ranking between topic, document queue of user and queue. Okay. So as we have understood, see, this is basically a document. This is basically a topic document of a This is basically a topic document of a user. For each user, you have a topic document. Okay? And then what happens is, that you have a query and you have a topic document. And simple search, what you do, you have some sort of overlap, or you for short things, the standard IR technique is having some cover distance. So cover distance is nothing, topic relevance into log of how many times it has been implemented. Okay. So you have the query that you have given the query politicians or Indian politicians. And you have a document where there is India, etc., etc., politics, politico, etc. Now you just see the cover distance. And then you try to say that So from the cover distance, what you get? You get for politics, so you get the frequency for, so what is in the document? In the document, for each topic, politics, you have a frequency. Sorry, I'll just go on. So we see these are small, big, etc. Why? Because this is signifying frequency. So in a document, what do we have? In a document, what do we have? We have for each user a topic and the number of times that the user has been listed on that topic. Okay? So you have topic and number of times the user has been listed on that. Fine? Okay? So these are the two things you have. So now when you say cover distance, what are you getting? You are getting a frequency. This user has been, so from cover distance, I find three topics from the topic document. Okay. I find three topics from the topic document, and for the time being, assume I just add the frequencies, and that frequency is the score of the user with respect to that. Should I repeat once more?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, I'm sorry, I should have covered a better slide. So, have all of us understood that corresponding to each user, there is a document? Is this clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. Okay. So, corresponding to each user, we have a document, and that, what does that document contain? That document contains a topic and the noun and the frequency. A topic and a frequency. Now, I give a query. When I give a query and I have some metric, some cover distance, tell some metric to match the query at the document. And what comes out from this metric? Each words and their frequency. Some words and their frequency. Okay? And now soon as I add up the frequency with respect to that query, that user has some value. Okay? And now I have all the users and their value and just rank. Okay? Clear? So, then nothing will come out, it will be zero. Because what I have a document of an user which has some topics, which has say movie, sports, etc. And my topic is say jujutsu. Nothing will come out. It will be zero. Okay. So only the relevant users will come out and a frequency will come out which says that which user is how much important. Okay? And then this is a very simple thing. So what we are doing, instead of taking all those 15 signals of PAL, we are just taking one signal, the list signal, ranking them based on list signal. So this is basically a very brave attempt, I will tell you, because there are so many signals going on. Just working on one signal, or anybody who have worked on search would tell that this will not work. Okay, anybody who has worked on search will tell that this will not work. Right? So now we deploy this in this public domain. Okay. Again, if you have your machine, you can just try this. So now the interesting thing is how to basically. So if you run this, you will see that there is politics and there is a location filter and we will begin to get. Okay? So we call this Cognos. Okay? So more important is it doesn't only work on popular topics, but it works on very niche topics like stem cell. If you give stem cell, you will begin to get a lot of stem cell. Okay? So now this is fine. We have developed a system, but since we have to publish a paper, one more most important thing is actually to have an evaluation. So we have to have a thorough evaluation with people around.
Sir?
Yeah.
Sir, you've been talking about frequency. So, sir, frequency should be like how much back should we start getting the frequency? For example, Arvind Kejriwal joined in politics 2 years ago. But if we take the frequency of being mentioned in politics, like Manmohan Singh would be getting it from 6 years now and Arvind Kejriwal would be getting it only 2 years now. But we know that Arvind Kejriwal is more trending. He is more popular. So how will that 4 years be forfeited in our frequency?
So it's a very nice question and a very relevant criticism to this work. It's a very relevant criticism to this work that we are really not taking timeliness into consideration. That I have told somebody is a... somebody getting IIT or becomes good forever. Okay. In our society, somebody cracking J becomes good forever. No? But that is not true, Parna. Okay. So there should be some evaluation system which should actually take into this concern. This work doesn't take that into consideration. Okay. Yeah.
Just example of the previous slide. Al Gore is an expert in politics.
Yeah.
He's not in politics.
Come on, he's in environment. No, this is not true. Al Gore is still an expert.
It is based on the user's input.
Yeah, so what he is telling is very right. Because one thing you understand, that this work is static that way. Once you are telling this guy is expert, and in social network what happens? Hardly people unfriend or hardly people unlist. Okay, unlist. So that thing is important. Okay, hardly people unfriend. So again we are telling, see the point is this, that point is for all our papers or all our work we are trying to bring to the community that this signal is very strong. Okay. We are not telling that this is the only signal. and this is the signal, or our work is the final work. So we are just, so this is what actually enthuses us also, that immediately you can think of many things building upon this system. Immediately, there are many things you will immediately begin to think that you can build up.
But by help of this location builder, it actually exploits the spatial information.
It actually. Okay. So let me go on to the, because this would be interesting for students also, that how we evaluate. So basically, the first thing I would tell you is about evaluating with the normal paper, the spot count paper. So the spot count paper, when we are publishing this, the spot count paper was the Wisdom 2011 paper was the main competitor. Okay. And so what was happening is that they were doing, when they did it, so interesting. So they did it on three topics. iPhone, oil spill, and there is another topic, I'm just forgetting. There is just three topics on which they did all this study. So let me take oil spill. Okay, and oil spill was very popular that time. It happened during that time when Scott Cowan was writing the paper. You remember the oil spill which happened in the Pacific. So what were their experts on oil spill? See, their experts. NWF, National Wildlife Federation, which is fine. Then Time is like Time magazine. Okay. Huffington Post, NOLA News, Reuters. Okay. So now this is another critic to your comment. See, these are not really experts in oil spill. Think carefully. These are not really experts in oil spill. But they can perhaps be considered expert during that time because they were reporting a lot of
information
during that time. But think carefully, fine. So in some way you can accept that they are experts at that time at least. But again, why do we go to Twitter? Do we go to Twitter to listen what is Reuters telling? So, in some way, they may be correct, but their information content is poor. Means their differential information content is very poor. Means if I consider normal media vis-a-vis social media, means with social media, then their information content is very poor. So, this is one important thing also we learned in IR, that it's not only information content, it is the differential information content which is very important. So now you see for us, it's BP America, the oil drum, okay, US Ocean Government, US Digital, so this is also US Coastal Guard, okay. So it's exactly bang on the expert which were talking about oil. Okay. So you can also see on iPhone also the same thing is happening. So, but fine. Spot count was fine because it was a paper we knew maybe spot count will be the reviewer, so we have to really tackle him. But more important was that there is a Twitter whom to follow service already. So that is more of a challenge. That there is a Twitter whom to service, commercial service, which is out there, and we are challenging that. Okay. This rarely happens in research paper, that you have to actually fight a commercial service. So now, ignoring all this really sophisticated things, okay, we are ignoring all these sophisticated things, we are rusty and we are rushing into some places where things will really fear to tread, okay. That they have whom to follow service, where Twitter, a multi-million dollar business, okay, where there are huge number of engineers working. Just try to appreciate the fight. Okay. Just try to appreciate the fight. We have two, three graduate students who are working on this, and there is Twitter whom to follow service. The commercially deployed service, money is made. Okay. So now what we have done. So actually, that way we were also not so small, so we have actually universities from three continents in so we were there. Max Planck, Germany was there, and that UFOP from Germany. So three universities from three continents were actually involved in this. So what we did, we deployed this and told the university people in these three places to evaluate why. So that was, it was running in the wild. Okay. We put it in the wild and told people to evaluate. So what was happening? 27 distinct queries were asked at least by. So it was in the wild. So people were typing anything. Okay. People were typing. So that was the idea, that let people do anything and then we'll evaluate. And then what? 27 distinct queries were asked at least by. And these 27 distinct queries we took. Right? And we were being judged by majority. So let me show what was given to the people. So this is something that we were not told search engine A. So we were giving it to these people. Search engine A, search engine B. And you have to click A beta, B beta. So both are equally good, both are equally bad. Okay, this is something that was coming. As soon as you type in a comment, result, type in a topic like politics, this will result. Okay? So this was there. So what was happening? Cognos, our system, does better on 12 queries. Okay, like what are the 12 queries? Computer science, Linux, Mac, Apple, iPad, India, Internet, Windows Phone, Photo, political journalists. Okay. It was better on. Twitter was better on 11 queries, music, Sachin Tendulkar, Angelina Jolie, Harry Potter, Metallica. What can you tell about this five?
They are person. Celebrity.
They are famous. They have a lot of signals going on in the system. Okay. So it is, you know, in search, the tail queries are the difficult queries. Okay. So it is always difficult to have the weak signals coming out. Okay. Strong signals are always, there are many things, there may be some mistake here and there, but it will fade. Okay. You can basically take this out. I don't know why. Anyway, cloud computing, maybe we give them, but I don't know why they perform better in IIT Kharagpur. But anyway, we didn't really find out they perform better in IIT Kharagpur. There were tired code queries. Microsoft, Dell, Kolkata, and Sanskrit as an official language. Sanskrit as an official language. What were the results coming? Tell me out of the four, which result was coming? That equally bad. Nobody was giving anything. It's okay. So both were equally bad. Was coming. So that was a tie. Okay. So now another interesting thing which happened. In many cases, both were equally good. Many people told that both are equally good. But then also, there were major differences. See this. Okay. This is something which was music and both were told equally good. Now, tell me which is our Twitter's.
Search
is
yours.
Why do you think so?
We are more celebrity in D, yeah, which are verified by Twitter, so it's trying to show them.
Fortunately, this is ours, this is Twitter. So the point is this, again, if you think both are equally important, but this, again, the differential information content, they were actually showing the organizations. And we, because, see, we ours. You can think that people follow celebrity. People doesn't follow organizations. And why is people visiting Twitter? People is visiting Twitter to follow celebrities, hear from them. If they want to hear from organization, they will go to their webpage and hear. Okay. So that way, both were equally good in that way that both have some music content coming out purely, but differentially, ours were much more personal, much more. Okay?
Did you also try on singer? Did you also try on the word singer rather than music? Did you also try on the word singer rather than music?
Query singer.
Okay. Yeah, I cannot.
Because Twitter may think of music as something else. You think of music where you have your list says music there.
No, see what is happening. Most probably, Capteri will also have the list singer and also have the list also be listed as singer and also be listed as music. So certainly, when I give singer, perhaps Twitter will also give Capteri and I will also give Capteri. That is true. Perhaps that is. But then, if I think of music, see, again, there are two things. You may argue that music means Sony music. Okay. But we have to think of the platform where we are working. We are working in Twitter, where music means this person. See, in Twitter, what is the trend? How are people behaving? People are behaving not in this way, in following organizations. People are following individuals. And we basically getting that back. So there is an absolute information content or absolute information requirement, and there is an expected information requirement in that platform or in that medium. Okay. So these are two different things. Yeah.
Those are the celebrity, they're institution. They are not personal.
So, but we are always interested in those type of institutes. Let's try to think that there is nothing wrong or right. There is something which users are requiring or users are wanting. And can we reflect that? See, it is ultimately a money business. Okay. And money is right. So what is users wanting? Users are wanting to hear from Shah Rukh Khan, who is perhaps an institution. I agree with you, who is perhaps an institution, but people want to hear from Shah Rukh Khan institution rather than Time magazine. So when I am going back and suggesting or giving a recommendation, so this is a recommendation sort of thing I am doing. When I am giving a recommendation, I have to understand what is the general trend in this media, what are people wanting, and accordingly give back the. Okay. Right? So, do you want me to stop or?
Yes.
Since people are hungry. Anyway, so, as long as the organizers tell, I continue. So the next problem, which is we have to update. So this is the next problem, which is You want to stop? So just I will take two more slides, finish this part, and okay. So the next problem is what we talked about. Two problems. One is the ranking, and the second is the additional crawling, continuous crawling. Okay. How to update. So now you see that what is happening is each month like 740k users are joining. Each month 740k users are joining. So that is a huge amount. So one thing is that if Twitter launches, it can launch a brute force crawling and try to do as much crawling and filtering out everybody. But can we have something focused, much more focused? So what we did this, if you do brute force, what is the problem? See, only one person is listed 10 or more times. So every 100 people joining, just one person is listed 10 or more times. Okay. And then 0.12% listed 100 times. So you have to hugely, okay. Which you will do perhaps if that means a lot. lot of money, which you will do, but in a universal setup, this is not possible. So what we did, we used the Hitz algorithm, hubs and opportunity. So what is happening? What are hubs? The hubs is that users who follow many experts and add them to the list. So now we took the Twitter graph, used Hitz algorithm, identified the topmost hubs, and just crawled. Instead of crawling everybody, we are crawling the topmost hub. And then what is happening is that if I crawl just 1 million hubs, I get 50% of the people who are listed 10 or more times, 50% of all people who are tested, listed more than 10 times, and 65% of people who are listed 100 or more. So this crawling basically solves at least the mean. So, yeah, I have told you that even we got Manmohan Singh, who joined just 5 days before our call. So, what would be the next topic? So, we did who is who and whom to follow. What should be the next topic? Let us just have our agenda, please. No, there's nothing of trending till now. Why should we follow someone? Yeah, he or she will be telling something. So the next would be what is happening. Okay.